Hi, this is Anne from Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to enable pressure sensitivity in Adobe Illustrator. And this is something you can only do if you have a Wacom tablet or another type of graphics tablet installed. So you need to have it plugged in and you need to have the driver software installed and all that. All right, let's get started. Okay, now not all brushes support pressure sensitivity. So I'm gonna create a new document and we'll just check to make sure our brush sensitivity is working. We'll go over here to print, I'll choose letter, and then we'll go to create. So first we'll wanna get our brushes palette open. Then we'll come over here to the flyout menu and go to brush library and choose artistic and calligraphic. Now a lot of these should be pressure sensitive if you have a Wacom tablet or another graphics tablet installed. So let's just click on one of these, and when we do that, it'll add it to our brushes over here. Then we can double click it and come over here to size and choose random. Okay, right now my pressure sensitivity is able to be selected, but just a second ago I could only choose fixed or random. So if you are only seeing those two, I have a few ways to troubleshoot this. Now, if you see pressure here and you're able to select it, go ahead and do that. And then you can change your variation. I usually change it to the same size as my size. So I'll put 15 here. We'll say okay. And then if we hit B on our keyboard to get to our brush, we can click and drag and have that nice pressure sensitivity that we like. By the way, when I'm doing this, I like to have my brush settings at super smooth so that it kind of fixes it for me. To do that, you just double click here and choose smooth. If you're in your brush settings and you're not able to choose pressure here, there are a few things you can try. First, we'll go to System Preferences, and then we'll choose Security and Privacy. Next, we'll come down here to Automation, and you'll want to make sure that Tablet Driver is checked here. Then you'll also click on Input Monitoring and make sure that both of these are checked. If you can't change them or they're grayed out, you can click on your lock and put in your password to make changes. Now, I tried this and it did not work for me. So if this isn't working for you still, you can also enable your Wacom brushes. So to do that, get in your hamburger menu and go to Open Brush Library, Wacom 6D Brushes, and then choose the 6D Art Pen Brushes. And when you do that, that'll bring up a bunch of them. I'll just choose this 35 one and I'll add it to my brushes. And now if I draw another line, that one automatically has pressure sensitivity in it for me. Now this did work, but I could not choose any of my calligraphic brushes. These are the only brushes that had sensitivity. You can get in here and double click and change your settings. And that way you'll end up with something that you like, and you can change your variation down here. We'll say okay. And we'll say apply to strokes, and we can also redraw a new line with pressure. So that way did work for me, but I also wanted to have access to all the other brushes that allow pressure sensitivity. By the way, while we're on that subject, not all brushes are set up to be pressure sensitive. So for example, like your art brushes are not going to have pressure sensitivity, but your calligraphic ones will. Another thing to try is to check your Wacom desktop center. So to do that, I'm gonna hit Command Spacebar to bring up Spotlight, and I'll just search for Wacom desktop center, and it'll bring up this app right here. And it might say under updates, you have an update. And if it does, go ahead and go into updates and you can install it right up here. Now, when I was testing this before, I did have an update that was ready to install. And once I installed it, all of my pressure sensitivity brushes were working again. So that was the main fix for me. But if that is still not working for you, you can reset or trash your preferences. Now this is kind of a last resort type thing because, you know, you have your Illustrator set up the way you like it, and it's a pain to go and set everything back up, all your preferences and, you know, your interface and all that stuff. So it is kind of a pain and I don't like doing it, but it's the last thing that I can think of that could possibly fix this problem. So to do that, all you have to do is shut down Illustrator, and then when you reopen it, hold Shift, Alt, and Command when restarting. If you're on a PC, that'll probably be Shift, Alt, and Control while restarting Illustrator. And you'll be asked if you want to reset your settings, and then you can just say yes. So those are all the fixes I know to get your pressure sensitivity working again in Adobe Illustrator. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.